Totally Yum is brought to you by Soup. Soup, the liquidy food that you can count on.
If I ever get my hands on those clowns, Oh no, this is something completely different.
I also happen to know about her evil twin sister, Deborah, who you brainwashed and thinking she was my wife, while Nina was undergoing a secretive nose job in South America, and who then became pregnant, but lost the baby and was kidnapped by pirates, and hasn't been seen again.
I forgot about that time. That was fun. Oh no, I have something even more disturbing to tell you. Your wife, Nina, is my daughter.
No!
And could you please turn the heating on in here? I'm freezing my tuchus off.
How was that, Ollie?
Having a good day, Morris?
Well, I do have a little bit of a cold right now, but
I don't actually care, okay? Good.
Anybody got soup?
Nobody's got soup, John.
I demand soup.
You can't demand anything.
I've been on this show for 47 years, and I want soup. Cream of asparagus. Cream of asparagus, or I go home right now.
Was I not clenching my teeth enough? Was that it? I have this problem with one of my incisors. I just can't clench my jaw like I used to.
Morris.
What?
Shut up. All right, listen. That was wretched, okay? Wretched. Where was the intensity? Where was the drama?
There'd be drama if I had soup.
Okay. Attention up here, Grandpa. You get soup after you nail this scene, all right?
It's in my contract that I get soup whenever I want.
Do you want me to have Alonzo's personality downloaded onto a computer so I can replace you with a CNC and have you fired? Because I can do that, all right? We're redoing the scene.
The whole thing?
Yes. The whole thing.
Oh, jeez.
This is ridiculous. I want double soup now.
There's no such thing as double. What is it, sweetheart?
My name's not sweetheart, it's Caitlin.
Ask yourself one question. Do I care?
I just got the ratings for last week's episode.
The answer is no.
I just got the ratings for last week's episode.
Dang it. But the plot line with the escaped mental patient, the poisonous troop, brute tree would really break the viewers.
I don't think people really understood the radioactive mango thing.
I'm not asking for your opinion. All right, babe? Why don't you do your job and set the props up again? We're redoing the scene.
Fine.
We haven't addressed the soup issue.
There is no soup issue.
There most definitely is a soup issue.
John, we'll deal with it after, okay? But right now, is there any way I can make some adjustments to my costume?
No.
Places!
I think. And 5, 4, 3, 2...
How nice of you to join me.
What do you want from me, Valencio? DiCarpaccio.
Why are you so suspicious? Can't I invite my friend over for a nice little chat? Sherry?
The last time I touched your sherry, I ended up in a mental hospital for 3 months. Then, convinced my half-brother to steal my family's fortune. So I think I'll decline the sherry this time, although it looks pretty good, and I am quite thirsty from riding my motorcycle. Over here.
As you wish, Jake Strong, as you wish. I would offer you soup, but I don't have soup.
I don't want any of it. Soup?
Too bad, because I could really use some soup.
Cut!
Places for scene 2, we need Eileen and Jessica! Eileen and Jessica!
Oh,
words for you, though. In a good way. Where's Eileen? She's in her dressing room. She's just so talented, don't you think? I just love her.
Eileen! Places! What? Places for scene two?
Fine.
All right, ladies, let's get some real fur flying in this one, okay?
Am I some kind of animal to you?
No, I
want conflict.
Like a cat fight, right? Because I'm a woman, is that what you think?
I'm a woman? Real fur flying?
Got it. Meow!
You're a twit.
Really? First grade work. You know what I like about about you? Your hair.
I love my hair too.
How about you and me go into another room and rehearse?
Okay.
Phil! Could you please refrain from hitting on the actresses for just a moment?
Stop it, Amy. You're just jealous.
Oh, yeah! I'm jealous of a washed-up, has-been, mediocre slime bag!
What did you just call me?
Not you, idiot! People, hey! Can we please save it for the cameras? All right, it's 5 o'clock. I can stay.
Oh, hold on!
Who are you again?
Hi, everyone. I'm Carrie, the new intern.
Hi! I'm so excited to be here. This is such an amazing opportunity for me.
I've dreamed about this my whole life!
You've dreamed about being an intern on a soap opera? You need better dreams.
This could be a stepping stone for me.
Look, what's her name?
Carly.
Internships exist to give family members of the production staff something to do, all right? You are going nowhere.
Oh, but I have something important to say. There's a lady here to see you, in a suit. Mario?
Mary?
That's it. She's like the excellent producer or something.
Executive producer, sweetheart. Dang it.
Everyone get out of here!
I didn't think we were going back to that scene.
Caitlin, you do not need to yell. We all heard you. Everyone get out here now!
I still have my suit.
John, get out here!
I will throw your body in the river when I'm done with you.
Darling, it's 5 o'clock and I'm beginning to turn into a pumpkin, so this better be quick. I've also got to get home.
You have been trapped in your house?
Pomeranians. I also had one named Senator Arlene Spector.
What happened to him?
Her. She ran away. I don't want to speak of it. Kidnapped, really. Held for ransom. It was a dark night. Raining. I just received a phone call from...
You did that episode 12 years ago, Sybil.
I don't know what happened to my dog, Ben! I'm worried.
Tell me I'm not doing it for any less than 2 million. I don't care if Matt Damon is in the picture. That's my rate! Well, Jimmy, I don't care. It's not like I'm gonna be doing soaps forever. Yeah, I know, slumming it with the little people. Have you talked to Spielberg? Well, get on the phone.
All right, everyone, look.
Don't be rude, okay? Jimmy, I want 2 cases of mineral water in my trailer always. When I drink one, I want another one in my hand, instantly. Got it? And aromatherapy candles. I know I don't have the part yet, but when I do...
Tyler!
Try to be rude, okay? Yeah, I don't need one. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? You just signed your death warrant, buddy. Death warrant.
Try it, poser. Everyone take a seat.
Oh, John.
How nice of you to finally join us. First things.
Hi, everyone. I'm Carrie.
No, that is not the first thing.
Oh, I thought we were introducing ourselves. You're gonna love it, dear Carrie.
You like to party?
Hey,
please! Sean, I have to make an announcement.
I get a little loopy at night, just so you know.
You're a little loopy during the day, too.
That's how I met my first husband! It was a dark night, raining. I'd just seen the ghost of my...
You did that one 28 years ago!
All right, thanks for that.
But what I'm trying to say is...
I'm glad you're all here.
Hi, Carrie! Hi, Ben. How nice of you to join us. Can I please have a round of applause for Mary?
I don't have a lot of time, so I'll make this brief. I know you've been hearing a lot of rumors about the future of the show.
There are rumors?
Most of them are true. Look, we're just not reaching our audience, so the network is thinking about killing the show.
What?
You can't do that!
It's about time.
They are.
This is insane. You can't just...
Hey, nothing's final yet. But unless you can show me some gain in productivity...
What are you talking about?
Here's the deal. You guys are the slowest shooting soap opera out there.
That's because we do quality.
No, it's because you argue about everything.
That's not true.
You're not.
Yes, it is.
I'll hunt you down.
You are proving my point. We can't afford to spend this much time on the show. You gotta speed it up. Here's the deal. Give me a high-quality, top-notch episode by tomorrow morning, and I'll recommend we keep the show running. We have to finish filming the show tonight.
Oh, come on. I get cranky at night.
You're cranky all the time.
And I have the right to be.
And Amy gets less attractive as the night goes on. Trust me, I've been there. High five.
Finish the show tonight or you're doomed.
We can do it.
Yeah, right?
I'm with you.
This is just too much for me emotionally. I mean, what am I to do without the show? I could go back into modeling. I'd have to get my headshots redone.
I know a guy. Top notch.
This is ridiculous. I'm going home.
No one's going home. I've had the intern.
That's me.
Lock all the doors from the outside. I've sent all the other workers home. You're trapped here.
You know, I've been a quiet person. I'm trying to be a pleasant person. It's a new thing my court ordered therapists have suggested. But let me say something here.
Oh, here we go.
Morris! Remember that time I apologized for biting you in the arm and sending you to the hospital?
I think I have post-traumatic stress disorder from that apology.
Yeah, well, most of me have now denounced violent. But there's still a part of me that can be convinced, okay?
Shutting up.
All right, Mrs. Director, lady, producer, whatever! You think we don't come to work every day and don't act our hearts out? Look at John!
Huh?
As far as I'm concerned, that man is acting personified. If you took the idea of a 60-year-old man with gout, the occasional hernia, and a strange need for soup, that would be it! And look at Amy over here!
She may be like 50 years old already.
I'm 39!
And she's getting old and disgusting, but she's still here acting her heart out! And the rest of the people on the cast may not have enough talent to make it in Hollywood, but they have just enough talent to make it on daytime TV. And that's good enough for doctor's offices, laundromats, and homeschooled kids. I say we have a good show. I say we have a great show. And if anyone has a problem with that, I will kick you in the head until you think differently. Right, everyone?
I'm not quite sure what your point is, but I like your tone, though.
Here it is! I'm not that stable. You do not want me in the rest of society. There is only one career with a person with as many personality disorders as I have could possibly make a living, and that's acting. So, if you take this away from me, I promise you, I will be the bag lady screaming outside of your house at 3 in the morning. Okay, I know where you live.
And I know where you live.
I know where everyone lives.
What?
Freedom of Information Act. You can find this stuff out.
Look, I'm on your side. I don't want a Chinese soap opera. They sing in that really weird way.
That's Chinese opera.
My Pomeranians love Chinese opera. Really get some howling.
Either way, but you gotta show it to me. Otherwise, you're all fired. Except Danielle, because I think I got a spot for you on the Chinese show. If you can learn the language.
I can totally do that. I have no standards at all.
Perfect.
That's what I'd like to hear. Until tomorrow, then. Sayonara. That's Japanese. Oh. Goodbye, then. In Chinese.
Wait. What's going on?
Oh, wake up, Tyler.
I am awake. Thank you very much. I just have more important things to think about. Like myself, and how awesome I am. Nice.
We're all gonna get fired unless we can finish this shoot tonight.
Okay, thanks. Now I know.
All right, gather around, everyone.
I'm not really one for emotional speeches, but... I got my start?
No, and I don't care either.
I was 8 years old.
My parents got me a video camera for Christmas. It ran on my imagination. But later, I got a real one. Used to make movies in my room, little shows I put on. I put my teddy bear in a dress.
You're sick.
Stuffed ducks in a tuxedo and staged a wedding between them and had a panda show up and start throwing punches, tearing and screaming at each other. And then sometimes I'd take my father's big disposable and shave little parts of my stuffed animals off and say they were injured during a fight. And then they'd be in a hospital with a frog doctor who was in love, but then there'd be another frog who looked the same, was also in love.
Does this story have a point?
Shh! What happened to the frog doctor? My point is, I am soap opera. When I'm showering in the morning, I'm thinking about soap opera. When I'm having breakfast, I'm thinking about soap opera. When I'm asleep, I'm having weird and disturbing dreams about soap opera. I don't have a husband. I don't have friends. I don't have anyone who loves me, and I'm really kind of sad and alone in this world. But I do have this. Who's with me?
I am.
Okay, good.
Can I change some of my lines?
No, you cannot take any of your
lines. I would not say the word substandard.
No.
Can I just say something here? I've had a great time working with you people, but I'm really poised to be a lot more famous than everyone. So
you're staying here.
Dang it! You just signed your death warrant, buddy. It's a line from the film I'm auditioning for. Death Warrant with Matt Damon.
And I'm insecure about my body.
All right, all of you, shut up, okay? We're doing this. We're doing the show, and none of us are leaving until we're all dead or this episode is finished. Got it? Moving on to scene three.
Please, it's for scene three.
I'll get you for this.
I'll put a sock in it.
I will, and then I'll get you.
Hey there, boss.
I don't have time,
Bill. I know, right? We've got time nowadays. Anyways, I've got a date.
Smoking. No.
In fact, I have 3 days.
No, you're not leaving.
Can I buy you a set?
No, go to your dressing room.
Man, you used to be cool. Now, you're disgusting. I'll remember this.
Place is in the hospital.
And 5, 4, 3.
I see you're feeling better, Mona.
Doctor, I had the dream again.
It's just a result of the sedative I gave you.
No, it's not! They're in trouble. I know they are.
You need to get a hold of yourself, Mona. There's a great big world out there that needs you. It needs your spirit, your energy. You can't let yourself be dragged down to the malaise of this swamp. I tell you to get up and live. Live like you've never lived before. And to all those who doubted you, you're gonna sign their death warrant.
Cut!
What?
Stop adding lines. This isn't an audition for your movie.
Did you get that take though? Can I have it for real?
No, you cannot have it for your reel.
I already deleted it.
Are you kidding me?
Take it back and do it again.
5, 4, 3, 2.
You need to get a hold of yourself, Mona.
I'm trying, Doctor, but the dream, it seems so real. I have to warn my grandchildren.
No, you need to sleep.
I have to get out of here.
No, you need to sleep. Sleep for a long, long time.
William!
Sequoia, I thought I told you never to come to me here.
I just needed to see you. They're saying such horrible things about you.
No.
Yes.
No.
It's not true, is it?
Of course it's not true.
You didn't give someone a hamster kidney instead of a real kidney? A bizarre transplant scan.
Where would I even get a hamster kidney? I don't even think hamsters have kidneys.
You didn't steal a hamster from a kindergarten class and then sold the real kidney on the black market to Serbian gangsters who in turn financed an independent film on Dungeons and Dragons.
Darling, it's me, Dr. William. I would never harm a hamster, and I don't like independent film or Serbians.
Oh, I'm so worried.
Don't be. Remember, there's a great big world out there that needs you. It needs your spirit, your energy. You can't let yourself be dragged down to the blaze of this swamp. I tell you to get up and live. Live like you've never lived before. And to all of dang it! You crossed me for the last time!
Go back. 5, 4, 3.
don't be. Here. Take these pills and you'll feel better.
What do these do?
Don't question me! I'm sorry. They'll call me for a time. Take them now.
Okay. I already feel better, and I'm no longer concerned about your possible organ harvesting.
Excellent. Now why don't you come sit down over here? Oh, you look so lovely today.
Thank you. Can I just sleep here?
Sure. You can sleep for a long, long time.
Oh, nurse! I believe we have another candidate for a kidney transplant.
I don't buy the laugh.
Are you kidding me?
That laugh was pathetic. It should be more like...
You don't even know you're going wild for me, but you are.
I'm not.
Your mind says no, but your pheromone receptors say yes.
Hi, Bill.
What's up, babe?
You smell nice.
I know.
Put your hormones in your pocket for a minute.
In my pocket.
Ollie, are you ready? Ollie, wake up. Man, can she sleep? Ollie? Ollie! Maybe someone killed her.
About time.
This is the last thing I needed today. The last thing. Wait, what's happening?
Murder.
Murder? Here? I'll stop him. You won't make me talk.
We're not filming right now, Sybil.
Oh. Oh, this is real?
Yeah, I can totally play it, Dish. I've got a really young face and a great plastic appeal. Hello? Hello? I just lost my service.
Are you still rehearsing?
No, that was a legitimate threat against you. Watch yourself.
And I heard Bill threatened her earlier.
Oh, come off it. If anyone here's the killer, it's Danielle.
You're right. It's Danielle. She's the killer.
But I'm the nicest person here.
But how do we all know it's not an act?
You could have been acting this whole time. It's what you do for a living, right? You're an actor.
We're all actors here.
You people are actors. I'm a star.
Try again, Harry.
much better than Ollie ever was.
I really, really think it's great that strong women are getting ahead in this business. Like, my whole career, I want a model that's right after you. Are you a size 6? Because I can totally wear those clothes. Oh. And 5, 4, 3, 2.
Thought I'd find you here.
It's my house!
That's why I thought I'd find you here. How are you, Eileen?
You can't just walk back into my life like this!
I can and I am. Doing it. Walking. You always liked the way I walked, didn't you?
Please leave! It's too painful, see? Too painful!
Is it any more painful than being massaged by porcupines? Because that's what I feel whenever I look at you. Look at me!
No!
Look at me!
No!
Look at me. You're still beautiful, Eileen.
Please stay strong. You're married. I've kept your wedding in secret.
I know. But there's something you never told me.
I told you my heart.
I spoke with Valencio di Carpathio today.
No!
Yes. And you know what he called me? My darling wife? My wife that I've loved constantly for the past 1.5 years after rescuing her from gypsies?
I know.
You couldn't tell me.
How could I? You wouldn't listen.
She's the daughter of my archenemy. I can't even look at her now. Every time I look at her, I see his evil face.
Then just turn her around.
It's just so terrible.
She might be his daughter, but she might not be evil. You could give her a chance.
No, it's over. My marriage is over.
Then what does that mean for us?
Eileen.
Jake Strong?
No, I can't do this. I can't do this.
I can't live knowing you're with another woman!
You must.
I can't!
You must. No, I can't be here. I can't see you. It's too painful.
Your brother was here today.
Gary?
No. Sebastian!
Sebastian Strong is not my brother. He's a genetic experiment gone wrong.
My daughter's going to marry him!
No, I'll kill him.
Don't try, Jake. He's been trained by Maven Seals and also went to ninja school. You don't stand a chance.
He must be stopped.
I know, but how?
What are you waiting for?
There's supposed to be a doorbell. Sequoia comes in.
You ready, Sequoia? Where's Carrie?
Probably with Bill.
Bill, I will murder you with my bare hands!
Maybe let's try something new today and not make any more death threats.
Bill, leave Carrie alone!
You are a sad, pathetic man and I never loved you! But if you change your mind, I'm still available!
You know, Amy, I'm single.
That must be very nice for you.
Let's keep going. At 5, 4, 3, 2.
He must be stopped.
I know, but how?
I hear the doorbell.
I didn't hear it.
I have amazing ears. She's dead. I'm sure of it.
What the heck is going on around here?
Well, she was in poor health.
She wasn't in poor health. She was murdered.
You can be in poor health and be murdered at the same time. It happened to my aunt. Get a life.
Someone killed her. Look, this is a knife.
It was Morris.
I was standing in front of you when it happened.
It could have been a slow-acting knife.
There's no such thing as a slow-acting knife. There's a murderer on the loose.
have to round everyone up so you can interrogate everyone.
There are two dead people now.
Think about how many people die on this planet every day, and you realize what a ridiculous statement that just was? Have a little perspective, please.
No, that was in 72. I remember I had gout, and you thought I said goat, and for some random reason, you love goats.
I never loved goats, you senile old codger.
Your third husband was a goat.
People, please, where's Tyler?
We have a crisis.
I know that!
So?
Why isn't anyone doing anything about the cell phone service?
Are we missing anyone? Where were you?
I got lost. It's so amazing back there.
All right. We've had another murder.
Oh, come on. Didn't we just do a murder? Do we have to keep using the same plots over and over again?
Someone killed Lily.
Ah! Oh, put on some pants, Bill.
We like that one.
You are disgusting and sad and pathetic.
And yet you were drawn to me. Like a parking cop to a flashing parking meter.
Yes.
Sorry, couldn't help myself.
Can I forgive you?
Bill, cool.
Or someone's gonna kill you.
No, no, no. Stop making threats. There are people getting killed.
She didn't even have a major role.
It doesn't matter.
To you, me.
There is a murderer amongst us.
Listen to college boy using the word like amongst.
This is like herding cats. Everyone sit down!
I want a cushy chair!
Just sit down! We're locked in. Someone has cut the cell phone service. Get it, Ruth Tyler. Ollie has been bludgeoned to death, and now Lily has been stabbed. The killer is sitting right here.
And we also have to finish filming our episode?
No, we don't. We can stop filming the episode, because that's what any sane, decent human beings would do.
Which is precisely why we'll continue to film the episode. The murderer would expect us to stop, so we won't.
Have you been replaced with a robot or something? You used to be nice.
That was before I assumed power. Now I've been corrupted. That sounds awesome. You wouldn't believe. Hey, I'm up for anything, really. I mean, I could talk about the murder, or I could film the scene. That's a great attitude, Danielle.
No, it's not. No, it's not.
Morris, if we allow the killer to stop us from filming this show and change who we are, then they're already won.
No, actually, if they kill people and get away with it, then they win.
I know a thing or two about murder, and it's this. If a murderer wants to be caught, he'll be caught. If he doesn't want to be caught, you won't catch him. Especially if he's careful and uses a technique no one's thought of before. But I don't know anything about that.
I think John's right. No use going after the killer.
Yeah. Totally. Sounds good. Moving on, we need to film this scene, but Lily's dead. I'll play your part. I already had a costume altered to fit me, and I memorized her lines backstage. Oh, I'm so enthusiastic.
So are you.
Great, okay. Places for Sequoia's entrance. Nice work, Carrie. And someone with the body.
Does nobody find it a little bit suspicious that she already had the lines memorized?
No, and I don't like those insinuations. Places. Thank you. And 5, 4, 3, 2.
He must be stopped.
I know, but how? It's the doorbell.
I know.
Sequoia! You're probably wondering why I look different. It was Dr. William. I don't trust him. Yes, but I changed my appearance for him because I thought he would like me better this way.
What are you doing here?
I have to tell you something. Something I've never told anyone. A secret.
Maybe I should go.
No! Stay! It concerns you too. Please, I feel just awful. Sometimes when I'm alone and staring at the moon, I think of what it would be like to be weightless, to float above the earth like an alien would in some strange, incomprehensible language. Maybe the alien wouldn't even have ears. He would just sort of have holes in the side of his head that he could also breathe through.
But I would twirl, how I would twirl out there in space, a spinning star of my own, giving out light and life to my own universe, and here on this planet I could see the...
That's nice.
No! Don't you see, Jake Strong? Don't you see the dazzling, mad, insane little place we call Earth? Sometimes I wish I was an octopus so I could have 8 arms and do lots of things at the same time. And also suckers, because those would be pretty cool. Although I imagine you might get them stuck against the wall.
Maybe you could tell us what's bothering you.
Oh, okay. Remember how when your baby was 6 months old, I was your babysitter?
Yes.
Well, I switched the baby with another baby I had in the back of my car and no one noticed.
What?
No!
Yay, my first scene.
We're gonna cut all that stuff out, right?
Carrie, maybe you can use some suspense when you tell them you switched the babies on them. We want suspense there.
No offense, Caitlin, but you don't know what you're talking about, and that was the stupidest idea I've ever heard.
All right. How is it possible that I didn't know she switched the babies at 6 months old? Wouldn't I have, like, seen the baby beforehand?
It's not like you were a good mother.
All right, but...
Maybe you were hypnotized.
By who?
By whom?
Shut up!
We'll just say I did. That's such a great idea I had just now. All right, let's take it back.
Before my impassioned monologue?
After your impassioned monologue. And remember, suspense
doesn't help me.
Try again. And 5, 4, 3, 2. Maybe you can tell us what's bothering you.
Oh, okay. Remember how when your baby was 6 months old, I was your babysitter?
Yeah, I remember that.
It was a night almost like this, sick and dark with a hint of alien invasion in the air. The baby wouldn't stop crying. She just wouldn't stop. She wouldn't stop.
It's okay.
I tried everything. I even tried poking her with a stick, but that didn't work. So I took her out to my car. I always had a spare baby in my car just in case. And I...
What did you do?
I switched the babies.
That's impossible. I would have known this.
No, you didn't, because I hypnotized you.
So, what you're saying? Is that the girl we believe is Jessica? Isn't our daughter?
No!
Hey, that was all right. Terry, there was a lot more suspense in that.
I was just inspired, you know? I have no idea where that came from.
Maybe it was when I told you to have more suspense in it.
Who knows?
All right, Brooke, what's next?
Well, let's see. That was scene 4, so I'm guessing the next scene will be scene 5. I'm just going out on a limb there, though.
All right, place it for scene 5. Oh, we need the gun. Carrie?
On it!
Caitlin, maybe sending Carrie to go get the gun isn't the smartest.
You just can't move on with your life, can you? Hey there. I'm looking at the script for my next scene. Some of these lines are pretty stupid, like this one. How are you? Who says that?
No, you cannot rewrite the script.
Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? You snot-nosed twit! I will eat you for breakfast with a side of hash browns. I've been on this show for 15 years, and I know a good line when I...
Amy, deep breaths.
I'm still not dating you, Morris.
That's not what I'm trying to...
This isn't finished. You hear me? I'm not done with you. Stuff a sock in it, Amy. Stuff 2 socks in it.
Yeah.
Ladies.
I love your touch of actors.
Caitlin, we have to stop filming.
You're really obsessing about this, and it's beginning to worry me. All right, let's get Sebastian and Valencia out here. And can we do something about this lighting? It's way too clear. I'd love to put a few more fake guns around, too. Is there any way we can put live bullets in any of that? Morris, I need you backstage in the dark away from everyone else. People, as much as possible, I'd like to be alone, in the dark, confused with a fake weapon. Can we try that?
What's the point in that?
I want some real authentic fear in these scenes. Let's do it. Morris, time for you to be alone. Here, take this fake gun.
I don't want the gun.
It might be real. I don't know. I haven't checked. Off stage now.
This is crazy.
Hey, we've got new leadership, okay? Crazy is how I do things. Let's go.
I don't give anything to do with this.
Can we get some
sound effects, please.
Can you sit more dramatically, please?
know what to know, sit down to you. It began when I was 6. I was a little boy then. My family was poor. My father dressed us up like monkeys and made us dance in the streets. But on my 6th birthday, he promised me something. He would take me to a place called the Magic Kingdom in Orlando, Florida. Oh, how glorious it looked to me then. The spires of the Blue Castle, the robotic figures of the Hall of Presidents, the giant chipmunk in a dress. I was in heaven, and that's when I saw him. An enormous rodent the size of my great uncle Sapka. An animal so powerful he looked like a god from mythology. Made flesh with saucers for ears and a smile that could swallow the world. He looked right at me and I was made anew. I followed that rodent. I would have followed that rodent to the edge of the universe. But when he thought no one was looking, he removed his own head. His head! He was no god. He was a pimply-faced teenager. Right then and there, I dedicated my life to evil. Later that night, I gathered a small group of street urchins and we ambushed the rodent as he was returning to the castle. He was large but clumsy and we toppled him quickly, our tiny fists raining blows of rage upon his battered body. When he lost consciousness, we tore off his head and held it aloft in triumph. My reign of terror had just begun. I spent the next few days stealing purses from old ladies, and we used the profits to hire a gang of Albanian dock workers. We held Snow White captive for days before they gave in to our demands. $500,000 and a plane ticket to Italy. I left my father there to draw sketches and dance his monkey dance. From there, it was easy to become an overlord of an international crime syndicate. All because of the rodent. So you see, your pathetic little concerns are of no importance to me. You can either stand with me, or I will destroy you. Because I am evil.
I'll never join you.
Certainly, you are disappointed. But let me tell you something else.
There's nothing you can tell me.
Your fiancé, Sebastian Strong.
Leave him alone!
My darling, he has been working for me for years.
I don't believe it.
And in fact, his name is not Sebastian Strong at all. It is Samantha Strong.
What? It's true, Jessica. Sebastian? Is that you?
Yes.
You look so different.
The wonders of modern plastic surgery.
You're like at least 3 inches shorter.
Special boots.
I lied to you, Jessica. I've been lying to you all along about my true identity, my gender, hair color. Facial features? I've changed them all back to the way they used to be. But I loved you. But why would you do that? Don't you understand? What would make a woman dress up as a man and pretend to be a man for 6 years, star in numerous schemes, wear an eye patch, and almost marry 2 different women before settling on you? It's so obvious, really.
Sherry.
Thank you. I love so.
Jessica, would you care for a drink now?
I think I would.
Too bad! You're not 21,
ha! I guess I'll just have a Coke then!
I only have the nearest cola brand from the supermarket.
You monster! Which brings us back to me. The person you used to know is Sebastian Strong. I have here my diary. Look upon it.
No!
Look upon it!
No!
I'll read it for you then. December 9th. Dear diary, I know it's been a long time since I've written to you, but I just had the most horriblest day. Like, this guy was in geometry class and he was so hot, but I'll skip forward. Sometimes I disguise myself as a man and wreak havoc upon the universe, and then at some dramatically intense point in the future really reveal that I was a man or a woman all along. So there it is. But I... You see, I felt alone and distant, like a traveler from a far-off land.
perhaps even from outer space. A creature with many arms and many thoughts and feelings of loneliness and sadness and a desire above all to be loved, and yet on the surface, really, really disgusting with sores and strange tentacles and things. Oh, and one more thing. I'm pregnant!
No!
Yay, my second scene. You were so good.
You were so good.
I was like, are you kidding me? She's so good.
You too, and you're so pretty.
You're pretty too, but you're so pretty I wish I could be you. I'd grow my hair the same way, and we'd wear the same clothes, and then I'd become you. But only one of us can live. Okay.
Can somebody please shoot both of these women?
Can I just point out that no one is going to believe that Sebastian Strong was Samantha Strong all along?
We did it in 75 with Carl. Remember Carl? He quit to be a dermatologist, and we had to replace him with that librarian who wandered in.
She was amazing.
And who do I have to kill to get some water around here?
No one. No one's killing anyone.
Well, where's my water? Am I going to have to go milk the cow myself?
What?
Like in the old days, when you wanted water, you went up to a cow and milked it.
That was an episode in 69, you old bat. When I grew up, we used a well.
Maybe in your fancy pants high-rise you used a well. In my village, we went to the cow instead. Here's your water, Sybil.
Thank you, Nameless Intern.
And Care, whatever. I play the part of Sequoia and Samantha Strong.
I hate to interrupt this lovely connection, but we've only got two more scenes and this episode is done.
Good. Then we can go home. I have been able to check the internet in almost 30 minutes. Who knows could be going on out there? I'm frightened.
I know you're all tired of hearing this, but...
Oh! My phone! Tyler Jacoto! Really? Really? No, we're all fine. No, thank you.
Who was that?
The police or something. They want to know about the gunshots and screaming.
And you didn't tell them three people have been murdered?
Oh. What's on my mind? I'll just call him back.
My servant's out again! Oh no! You know what? Enough of this.
You're right! I'm mad as heck, and I'm not gonna take this anymore! They can take away our phones, but they will never take away our freedom!
Five, four, three, two.
is a hospital.
Don't touch me! Get your hands off of me! You're an evil doctor!
You found my secret, old woman! I won't save you now!
What's going on here?
She's having a hallucinatory episode! You have to help me restrain her!
No! He's evil!
She's hallucinating!
He's been guarding me! Please!
Darling, you choose either the ramblings of a crazy old woman or the words of your one true love, who also happens to be a doctor and is wearing a doctor's lab coat. Choose correctly, or you could be signing your death
warrant. I'm so confused, Dr. William. I love you, and I completely changed my personality and appearance for you, but I
love you too. In fact, will you marry me?
I don't know what to say.
Say yes.
But you have to explain something to me first. How did I get strange star inside my stomach? Did you harvest my kidneys?
Don't worry about your kidneys. I can give you one back.
You stole my kidneys!
You don't need both of them. Woman, I'm trying to do a love scene here, but you can't just pretend to die in the middle of a scene, Sybil.
I thought it was really realistic, though.
That was the totally wrong time to do that, Sybil. Sybil?
She's probably dead.
Can you hear us?
Stand back, everyone. I'm playing a doctor. She's been poisoned.
In real life or in the show?
She's a really good actor.
Either that, or she just died of old age, in which case it's quite a coincidence.
There! You see? Now someone else has been killed.
How do you know she died?
I heard you say it. Everyone get out here!
Alright, how many times do we have to go through this?
Everyone, there has been another murder.
Really, kid?
But I know who the killer is.
Hold on there, little taco. I'm running this show.
No, actually, I'm the only one who...
Amy Mouse! FBI, read it and weep.
You're an FBI agent? That is so cool!
I want to be an FBI agent.
Sorry, we don't let chicks in.
Good.
No, I'm sorry. You've been on this show for 15 years. You're not an FBI agent.
Deep undercover.
For what reason?
This is awesome!
I made out with FBI.
What you don't realize is that the FBI has a lot of secret agents. A lot. Close to 2 million. In most every situation, the crowd gathers, one abuses a secret informant sending vital information back to the government. I don't care where you are. Preschool, a church, a theater attending a show. Several are undercover government agents recording and transmitting your every word, thought, and deed. Why? Because your government loves you.
This is insane.
Insane or all too sane?
Oh! All too sane.
That's right. My job here is to solve these murders.
So, where were you, say, while the last three people were getting killed?
My job is to solve murders, not stop them. If I were to stop the murders, then I wouldn't have any murders to solve, now would I? Then I wouldn't be doing my job. That's how the government works. Efficiency, efficiency, efficiency.
I am so blown away by this.
So let's all have a seat and bring the criminal to justice.
Sounds good.
Finally, some justice around here.
At least somebody's doing something.
This is exciting.
Excuse me? Excuse me? Now you sit, now you listen. I have been trying to get you people to understand that there is a murderer on the loose for the last hour. Three more people have been killed.
But we shot some great scenes.
How do you know she's FBI? Huh? Maybe she's the killer.
She's
got that little badge thing that says FBI on it. That's how you know.
It could be fake.
Hello? FBI agents don't lie. It's in their rules.
All right, genius. Who's the killer?
Killers.
Not so fast, Morris. There's an order to this. We have 3 murders.
4.
I thought that there were 3. Ollie, Bill, Sybil.
You forgot Lily.
Would you just let her do her job?
Okay, 4 murders.
Now the question is, do we all live by the same person?
Or do we have 4 separate ones?
This is insane. I know who the killer is.
No, you don't.
Yes, I do. It was Carrie.
Oh, come on. Carrie?
Think about it. How many people have been killed in the last 30 years? And since the show has been around? None.
Not exactly true.
How many people in the last 9 hours since she got here? 4.
Carrie wouldn't hurt a fly.
You just hate women, don't you? You despise women because you have saggy buttocks.
No, guys, listen.
I'm running this show. Sit down.
Carrie handed Sybil water. She had a gun backstage when Bill was killed. She's already memorized everyone's part. She's taking everyone's place. Did none of you even find it a little bit suspicious that she already had her own eye patch, for goodness sakes? She's the killer. It's so obvious it makes my brain hurt. Just confess it, Carrie. Confess you are the cold-blooded killer.
Nope. Well, that's good enough for me. What a relief.
You thought she was the killer. You really tried to ignore it for a second.
I'm afraid your wild accusations have no merit, Morris. Carrie is clearly not the killer because that would be too obvious. So sit down, buckle your seatbelts, and get ready for a ride on the Truth Express. It's gonna hurt if you're the killer. No! I'm afraid our killer is much more sneakier than that. Which is why it might be... Danielle!
I knew it. You already accused me once.
She has an alibi. Bill vouched for her. Mm-hmm.
And where is Bill now? Coincidence? We already established her motive for wanting Ollie dead. Acting practice. Now why would you want Lily dead?
Ooh, I know.
Carrie, with Lily dead, she could weasel her way into the cast.
No, that's your reason.
Oh, I don't know then.
Allow me to present light to this situation. I think I understand female psychology better than anyone here. You see, when two youngish, attractive females are placed within a cage, they inevitably begin a struggle to the death to compete for the dominant male. Which in this case, would be me. All the time the spouser faces in snide looks, comments about clothing bought at the Gap, and the occasional devastating text message. And also knives.
No, I liked Lily. Even though she was cruel and terrible to me, she was my friend.
Which is why she had to die.
John's theory makes a lot of sense. I think we all know why she wanted to kill Bill. He had spurred her attentions and begun to flirt with other women on the cast.
No, that's your reason for wanting to kill Bill.
Sorry, I'm out of practice on this whole secret agent thing.
I can answer this one. I did want Bill dead. You monster! You ever really like someone? A lot. Right? And I like most people, and I'm a great person on the outside. And really, to be fair, I thought Bill was a tremendous actor, and a really gentle soul.
He wasn't gentle all the time.
And he talked about how much he enjoyed watching sunsets, and walking on beaches, and making out and everything. And that sure was nice, but I hated him. I hated him with the white hot intensity of 1,000 suns. I mean, I really wanted to kill him in horrible, horrible ways.
and I had dreams about making a pool of acid and dipping him into it extremely. While he begged for forgiveness, and his prayers would sound like angels in my mind, and then I would. But I didn't kill him. I just wanted to kill him every second of every day.
Why were you dating him?
I have a hard time saying no to that.
Oh, so there's one question I have.
I'm not interested, Morris. We're just friends, okay?
I wasn't gonna ask you out on a date.
I just feel how I feel.
Which brings us to Sybil, which, if you ask me, was just overkill. She was old. Why would anyone want to kill her?
Because she was an evil old witch.
Quiet, John!
I think I understand. If she killed Ollie to practice her acting, what if she killed Sybil to practice her acting some more?
Hold on.
Yes.
You're saying she killed two people. Not one, but two. Just so she can act like she didn't kill two people?
Yes. It all makes sense.
If acting innocent after killing one person was difficult, then acting innocent after killing two people would be even more difficult. Oh, you are going away for a long time, young man. Two places is not much time, Chinese. Except for the few hours you're allowed to walk the yard. Confess!
I didn't do it. Please, doesn't anyone believe me?
I believe you.
Thanks, Morris, but I know you're just saying that because you're interested in more relationship than I can give you.
Danielle didn't kill anyone. Think about it. She's not even that good of an actress.
Perfect space for a younger than an old man. A person named Lily. She was crazy, so she never slept. So she got here at 6 a.m., which is a full 15 minutes before your arrival. She took your precious parking spot. And in fact, I overheard a confrontation you had with her only 3 days ago. I will now choose actors to recreate that conversation.
Okay, I be John? I'll be Lily.
Excuse me, young lady. I have noticed you've taken my parking spot, and as a kind elderly man, I would appreciate it if you could—
Oh, buzz off, Wanka. I'll park wherever I want to park, and there's nothing you can do to stop me.
Why, you whippersnapper, someday soon I'm going to take a knife and stab you in the back with it.
Oh, you try it.
End scene.
That was spectacular.
Moses was savage. Set and match.
There are still two more murders.
I'm getting to it. Bill, you killed because he took two muffins when you were only clearly allotted one. And you took out Sybil because you're just plain cranky and needed attention.
Bravo, Agent Amy, bravo. An excellent performance. Unfortunately, fuck. Did I want to kill Ollie? Yes. Did I want to kill Lily because she took my parking spot? Of course. And did I want to see Bill die because he took two muffins when we're only supposed to get one? Who wouldn't? And did I want to kill Sybil because I'm generally a cantankerous old coot who doesn't like anybody? Yes. You're forgetting one thing, though. I'm oh so lazy. And to kill that many people takes a lot of work. Besides, with the four of them dead, I don't have as much to complain about. That makes me unhappy and crankier still. So, would I have liked to go on a killing spree? Sure. Did I do it? Nope. I'd rather eat soup.
Dang it! Well, that means the only logical suspect left is...
Kira!
Tyler!
I'm sorry?
Tyler!
No, I'm sorry. I haven't paid attention. The internet came back on, so I've been Googling myself. I also have a Twitter feed to send to. See?
Ooh, bored. Can't wait to get out of TV. That's funny.
You follow me on Twitter?
Yeah.
What the heck are you people talking about? Twitter?
It's a new technology that's completely entranced everyone. And will be gone within 3 years.
Well, please go ahead. I'm sorry I haven't paid attention closely.
To recap, there are 3 murders.
4
murders. I'm an FBI agent. John, Danielle, Carrie, and Brooke have been cleared. You are the only logical suspect left.
Except for yourself and Morris.
I don't think I'm a suspect here, actually.
Oh, really? Oh, really? Let us present a picture of a man to the jury. A picture of a man named Morris Nyborg. This man right here.
I was actually on camera during one of the murders.
How convenient. Too convenient. Let's examine this man for a moment, shall we? A man playing the role of Jake Strong, the romantic, dashing soap opera hero. A soap opera hero who did not make Soap Opera Digest list of 10 hunkiest daytime stars. A soap opera hero so insecure that he would sew padding into the backside of his pants in order to make his buttocks more shapely. A soap opera hero desperately, madly in love with the woman who played his daughter on the show, Danielle Ferris.
That's me.
Why does everyone think I'm in love with her?
You're in love with me? Oh, Morris, I don't feel the same way about you.
I know that.
So how does this not terribly hunky daytime star do to win the love of women who played mother and daughter? Which is sick, by the way. He sets up to prove it the only way he knows how. By killing people. In his own mind, in the twisted logic used by those who are desperate for attention and shapely mirror ends,
Only through brutal, vicious killing can a man truly be a man. Think of hunters or the NRA. Unfortunately, the ladies didn't come around, did they? After Ollie, you figured one of them would fall into your arms, but you didn't count on Bill.
He was dreamy.
We used to call him El Matador.
So you dispatched him with a gunshot, and through an ingenious ninjutsu technique known as slow knife, you killed Billy while still on camera. Amazing, isn't it?
Slow knife? What is slow knife?
Shall I show you? Watch carefully, everyone, as I shall appear to do nothing, but in fact, slow knife will be occurring. Brooke, when I tell you to, duck.
Why?
Because the slow knife is coming. It's more dramatic this way. Now, slow knife. Duck!
You just dropped the knife on the ground. That was not slow knife.
Because I am not a ninja. But only a ninja would know that I had not executed slow knife properly. Therefore, ladies and gentlemen, the killer.
I didn't kill anyone. There's no such thing as slow knife.
Only a ninja would know there's no such thing as slow knife.
Makes sense to me. Book him!
Think about it. Who's been the one pressuring us to discover the killer all along? Morris, why would he do that? To deflect attention away from himself. Bingo.
Let's paint another picture, shall we? A picture of Tyler Tripodo.
Ooh, do we have paints?
A man so obsessed with fame, he would do anything, even kill for it.
You say that like it's a bad thing.
He's up for a big movie.
With Matt Damon.
I love him.
But he might not get the part. So what does he do? He sets up a scandal so that casting him would be viewed as a publicity stunt. First Ollie, then his co-stars. If he can't be a big star on this show, then he'd make sure that this show was big enough to launch the rest of his career.
I was on camera when Sybil was killed.
I was on camera when Lily was killed.
He explained that. Slow knife.
And there's no such thing as slow poison?
That would be ridiculous.
Not only did I not kill Sybil, there's certainly no way I could have killed Bill. I can't shoot a gun.
Oh, come on.
No, seriously. Does anyone have a gun I can borrow?
Oh, here.
Look, I am wildly confident with this thing! I can't even manage that! I couldn't have shot Bill!
Pansy.
Now there's one more piece of evidence we haven't considered.
How about the murder weapon, which you have in your hand, which Carrie handed to you? Doesn't that make you slightly suspicious?
I'm not referring to the gun. I'm referring to the note. This note. Wait, where's the note?
I think it's still pinned to Bill's corpse.
Hold on. Carrie, can you go get the note?
Sure thing.
You're sending Carrie to go get it? Are you insane?
It's okay. It's part of my job description.
Amy, this is so simple a 4-year-old child can figure it out.
Nonsense. 4-year-olds don't know nothing.
It's Carrie. She is the back. Give me the trouble.
And I'm back, miss. Me, here's the note.
Now, the note says, dear cast members of The Bold and the Young, tonight, I'm going to kill you all.
Stop that.
What we have here is the killer's handwriting. Evidence. Now, I find something suspicious about the I in tonight. It's dotted with a heart.
I knew that.
I knew that too.
Me too.
You're discharged. About the I heart thing, not the murders.
Okay, so that's inconclusive.
I guess we'll just have to film the final scene then.
No, I know who the killer is.
Well, speak up, I'm all ears.
Okay, now I know you all have the intention of slow gerbils, so I'm going to make this as simple as possible. There's only one person here that had the opportunity and the motive to kill all four people.
Really?
Yes, really. She's killed through a variety of means, but for the same reason. She wants nothing more than to take our places. She's the worst stalker any of us have ever had. It's...
Slow night! It was slow night!
What?
Morris Steinberg, you are under arrest for the murders of Little Sybil Brooks and
Lily.
Thank you.
Ow. Ma'am.
Oh. Brooks not dead?
Are you all right?
Yeah, I wore a lot of padded clothing. It just barely grazed me.
But who stabbed you? It wasn't Carrie.
I was over there. It was.
Okay, stop trying to kill Brooke!
Don't worry, everyone. I'm still playing the doctor.
That means it has to be...
me.
The evil producer?
Hi,
Mary. You're the killer?
Yep.
So why?
Whoa. You see how much you're trending on Google right now? Apparently there's all sorts of buzz over the five people that were murdered. We're hot, baby! We're hot!
All right.
What better way to increase our ratings than create a disastrous spectacle of murder and intrigue? It's perfect. When a star dies on a television show, ratings go through the roof. When four stars and the director die, you're talking a ratings tsunami. So the good news for the survivors is the show won't be canceled.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Finally a happy ending.
But this is insane.
Oh God, you're not starting this again, are you?
You'll never get away with this.
I know you're thinking, how can she possibly get away with this?
That's not what I was thinking, but close.
Well, I said four stars with him. So far, there have been three deaths. Four star to die, of course, is a murderer, and is so consumed with guilt that he, or she, commits suicide afterwards, and the rest of us are free to go on with their lives.
I'm listening.
Here's the deal. You don't say anything, and you can make him the hottest soap opera on television. Salaries go up, stars are all possible movie deals. If you keep your mouth shut, if you think you need to tell the truth about things, well, you become the killer.
That makes sense. Quick question. What if all of us take the deal?
Then Sybil was the killer and she felt so bad about it, she poisoned herself.
That still makes sense. Well, everyone?
I'll take the deal.
Hey, I'm up for anything, really.
Yay! Is that a yes or a no, John?
Yes. I guess.
I'm just happy to be the director.
Amy? Morris?
Well, while working for the FBI, I've learned that I have a certain moral flexibility. So, I guess this is one of those things I could stomach for the greater good.
It's just you, Morris. What do you say? Want to be on a hit show?
I have some very serious ethical reservations
I'll be a man.
Can I be Jake Strong?
Carrie, please. We have understudies ready.
Well, Morris?
I'm afraid I'm going to have to decline your offer, Miles. Mary, you can try and kill me if you want.
Oh, I'll do more than try. Oh.
Slow night! I didn't do anything.
Oh, that one was me. I interned for some ninjas before this.
That is so cool!
She's dead.
How do you know?
I could just tell.
Well, that's that. Everything's all wrapped up.
But I guess we'll have to take Carrie to the police now.
Oh, no. I don't think so.
I'm the producer of the show now.
But...
Morris, I think you owe Carrie an apology.
All right. Carrie, I'm sorry. I thought all the evidence was pointing towards you being the killer. But it turns out you only killed one person. And that makes you all right in my book.
I'm still not gonna date you, Morris.
Right on!
You know, I could probably use some help getting these scenes out and get stabbed. And shot.
You look fine to me.
Let's film the final scene.
Yay! I'm really not feeling well over here.
Oh man, not bruh.
Mexico, get some facial reconstruction. Perhaps
want to appear more evil. Like movie producing.
Yes.
You do a great job producing the show, honey. But this is the last time I cover up a quadruple murder for you, honey.
Thank you. You're the best mom ever. Happy ending.